Father, have your way, oh God, in this house today. You're so worthy to be praised. And we lift up your holy name.
Death could not hold, nail torn before, you silenced the voice of sin. Death could not hold you.
Could not hold.
The veil tore before you.
The veil tore before you.
Silence
the voice of sin.
Death could not hold you.
The veil could not hold you. The veil tore before you. It silenced the voice of sin and grace.
Break every chain.
To break every chain. Till I
Come on, lift those hands up all over this room if you can. Come on, let's just, if you're able to, lift up those two holy hands all over the room. Come on, somebody help me to bless the name of the Lord in this house this morning. Isn't it good to be in God's house today? Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. So good to be in God's house with you. Those of you that are joining us through the live stream, I welcome you as well. Thank you so much for being here. Listen, we're going to transition, but I'm just going to tell you how I feel in my heart. I feel like we're inching close to something, and I don't want to miss a divine opportunity or miss God wanting to accomplish and do something in this place. So I know we've been worshiping for a few minutes, and I've asked them to continue to worship. Hopefully when you came in, you got a set of communion elements when you walked in. If you didn't get one, just raise your hand, and our ushers will make sure that you have one in your hand. We're going to worship the Lord with communion here in just a moment. Now, you don't have to make your way back to your seat. You can stay in the altar, because I want this communion time to not be so super formal, but to be very, very worshipful. I think communion ought to be worshipful. It's, after all, it's remembering what Jesus Christ did for us. Amen. Is there anybody in the room today that's grateful? I mean, is there anybody in the room today that is grateful for what Jesus has accomplished and what Jesus has done in your life? Hasn't he been good to you? Come on, I said, hasn't he been good to you today? Amen, amen, and amen. Let's get ready to worship the Lord in just a moment with communion, but I don't know. I'm just going to turn you all loose and let you do what you got to do there. I'll come back maybe and we'll do communion together, but I just want to worship for a second longer.
Come on, my soul.
come on, take that little wafer part out of your communion elements right now. Just hold it in your hand. Come on, we're going to worship. While we're worshiping, we're going to receive communion together. I want them to keep singing, but on the night that he was betrayed, he took this bread and he said, "This is my body that was given to you. It was given for you, and it's when you eat this, I want you to do it in remembrance of me. I'm grateful for the body. I'm grateful for what he has done for us by giving us the body." There are people in this room right now worshiping. I see two of them right now. Recently, as earlier as this year, two men have been healed from cancer in their bodies. They had the diagnosis of cancer. Then they went back after prayer, and they had the doctor's report saying that there is no more cancer in their body. Why? Because over 2,000 years ago, God became flesh and dwelt among men. And he said, "I give my body. I give my body for the, not just the remission of sins, but he gives us his body so that with his stripes, we are healed." Is there anybody in the room that still believes in healing today? Just hold that wafer in front of you. Hold that body in front of you, that bread in front of you. Father, we're so grateful and thankful. We express our heartfelt gratitude. Thank you for giving of your body for us. Thank you for taking the beating that we no doubt deserve. Thank you for taking the crown of thorns and having it pushed into your scalp. Thank you, God, for doing that for us, for receiving it for us, God, when it should have been us. You did it on our behalf. And we take this, God, and we break this bread. We do it in honor, and we do it in remembrance of you. We thank you, God. Said, "This is the new covenant in my blood. As often as you drink this, do it in remembrance of me." While I am extraordinarily grateful for the bread, and while I'm extraordinarily grateful for what it symbolizes, I am extraordinarily grateful for this cup of juice and what it symbolizes. It symbolizes the shed blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Without this, there would be no remission of sin whatsoever at all. And I just want you to take that and hold that up there in front of you, and out of your own heart and with your own mouth, I just want you to say, "Jesus, thank you. Jesus, thank you. Jesus, thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Thank you for giving this blood on Calvary's cross. Thank you, God, for taking those nails into your hands and into your feet, the spear into your side. Thank you for every drop of blood that you shed on behalf of me, this wretched sinner. Thank you, God, for what this cup represents. Thank you, God, that without it, Lord, there would be no redemption. Without it, God, there would be no repudiation of sin. Without it, God, there would be no connecting with you. Without it, God, we'd still be lost. We'd still be hopeless. We'd still be destitute. We'd still be broken. But because of you and what you did and what this cup represents, we say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jesus. 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 And when you drink this, I want you, with the loudest praise that you have to offer, offer him. Don't reserve and don't hold back. This is Palm Sunday. This is a Sunday where Jesus said, if they are quiet, then rocks will cry out. We don't want any rocks crying out today. Amen. Let's drink together.
got a lion inside those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Come on, my, come on, my,
come on, my soul.
Yeah.